Suppose A is a matrix, square matrix, and it has the property, I better put glasses on to get it right. A cube equal A. A cube equal A. So, first question, is A sure to be invertible? If A cubed equals A, is A sure to be invertible? Answer, no, because the zero matrix could has zero cube equals zero. Is the determinant zero? No, because the matrix might be the identity matrix. You see how I answer it by just thinking of an example.
Yes.
So the identity matrix would have A cubed equal A. And its determinant is one. So the sum of the diagonal elements of A is one. No, certainly not, because A could be the identity
Yes,
where the
yes.
sum is n, or A could be the zero matrix. Now, here, the fourth possibility to ask, A and A squared have the same rank. Now, is that true? Ha! Again, let me ask the question. If A cubed equals A, does that tell us that A, that certainly tells us that A and A cubed have the same rank. Does A squared have that same rank? Yes, it does. Because A squared, the rank of A squared might be that might equal the rank of A or smaller, it couldn't be larger. The rank can't grow when you multiply. And so A squared, the rank of A squared is not bigger than the rank of A. But then if we multiply again to get A cubed, that's the same as our original A. So that's telling us that the rank can't go down because we're getting back to the same matrix. So A and A squared do have the same rank. The solution to the question. If A cubed equal A, then A and A squared have the same rank. Okay. And many of the audience can think about similar questions about rank of a matrix. The rank of a matrix is very important.